Live from Fort Wayne, Indiana. In the first game of the Palmer Pro Invitational, we'll have back-to-back games all night. I've got the first three, then it'll be Chris Trefty coming to you for play-by-play action. But right now, he's on color. He is down between the benches right now. What's up, Chris?
What's up, George? As you said it, it's that time. It's an exciting time for State Wars 12, the Pro Invitational, finally here. And each year, we keep saying it's going to get better and better with all they're doing for this Pro Invitational. And I'm excited. Just as I know you are, it's a packed house here in Fort Wayne. It's a smaller facility than in St. Louis in terms of crowd, which is going to make it look even more full, and it's going to make for a great environment. And we got an excellent matchup here in matchup number one of the Invitational.
I think I still got your red shirt up here, Trefty. I'm going to wear that all day today because it fits me better. It has my muscles all cuddled up and everything in it, so I'm going to wear that.
My muscles are too big for that shirt, so go ahead.
Oh, boy, nice one, Trefty. But listen, as we come into this game, folks, you got to remember we're running 2 18-minute stop time periods here for the Palmer Pro Invitational. So 2 18-minute stop time periods. They're running a three-point system, so 3 points for regulation win, 2 points for shootout win, 1 point for shootout loss, no points for regulation loss. So they also have the over and back rule that starts at the red line on a delayed penalty. So those are just a few things that we have here in the Pro Division. But we're getting ready to drop the puck on game number one here at the Palmer Pro Invitational. It's the Palmer Cyclones and the Torrent Roadrunners. Ready to go.
Got the best seat in the house down here, George.
I can see that.
Above the glass. Again, hopefully looking better than Pierre Maguire. Hopefully sound better as well. Let's go.
I would hope so. Face-off controlled by the Roadrunners. It's Max Halvorsen back to recover. Plays it back in behind his own net. Roadrunners lose control quickly as Travis Noah is on it. They tried to center it in front. Halvorsen takes it away and tips it up on the wing, and back come the Roadrunners, 2-on-1. Roadrunners coming in over the line. Here's a chance, a shot fired wide, and it goes out of play, but it's not blown. Now the referee does blow it, and we'll have our first stoppage in play, 28 seconds in.
George, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think the Roadrunners have to get off to a good start. They got to get some momentum, maybe get on the board early. They're overmatching this game in terms of talent in some aspects, so they really have to come out strong and have a good first 5 minutes and lead to a good first period.
They have to, and that's where you'll get your confidence from in games like this, because you know you're playing a team that should win the game in Palma, but you have to make sure you come out not worried about that. You're not worried about who should win the game. You just want to play as you can win the game. So remember, 2 18-minute stop time periods here. We're less than a minute in. And it's the Roadrunners starting away. Austin Rezegi turns, leaves it for Halvorsen, fires and scores!
The youngster getting it done. We talked about the first 5 minutes. They need to get on the board early, and that's exactly what they do. 17:05, we're not even a full minute into period number one, and maybe the youngest or second youngest, because you got little DiMartino in the lineup as well, in the entire game. Shows that age doesn't matter. Walks in, beautiful shot. Roadrunners take the early lead.
Halvorsen gives the Roadrunners a 1-0 lead less than a minute into this game. And that's just what you talked about, Trefty, getting the early start here. And now Palma starts back. Cyclone starting away with Jordan Thomas in behind the net. Thomas taken off by Adam Swims. They still do battle in behind the net, coming out with the puck now for the Roadrunners. Is Swims. Swims get pressured there by Travis Noe. Dumped up on the wing, Sokol racing after it. That's tipped right away by Joey Duran of Palma. Walters fans on it. Walters can't get it. Marker tips it away, and back come the Roadrunners. Already up 1-0. Left there in the slot, Timmy Janke gives it to Sokol, and Sokol will turn it back into his own end to Adam Swims. Swims now wants to come out of his zone with it. Swims leaves it there for Timmy Janke. Janke looking to go in behind his own goaltender, Keith Johnson, one of the strongest goaltenders in the game. Roadrunners set things up. Man-to-man system played here by the Cyclones.
Roadrunners doing an excellent job, George, of controlling the pace of this game. They're playing their game right now. They're forcing the Cyclones to have to come at them and play their game. Cyclones are a patient team, but the Roadrunners do an excellent job here in the early going.
Joey DiMartino leaves it back behind his own net. Slow pace of this game here. The beginning of it was fast pace as the Roadrunners picked that pace up. Coming up the wing is Tommy Heinzman. Heinzman looks, drops to Okada, was in his skate, so back come the Cyclones. Ty Walser, longtime Revision Vanquish player. Walser feeds it in. That shot stopped by Keith Johnson. Goes along the boards, played in behind the net. And the Roadrunners start out with it one more time. Up on the wing is DiMartino. Joey D has it. Chucked off the puck by Rob Alexander. Alexander takes it again, dropped to Sean Garsh, back to Garsh, tried to cut to the middle, taken away. Heinzman very calmly on the back check, takes it in behind his own net to set things up. He's pressured in there by Rob Alexander. Alexander tried to take the puck, he still does battle back there, and it's recovered by Sean Garsh. Garsh has it, fires one, Keith Johnson makes a save, and he'll hang on. 14:41 left in the first period, it's a 1-0 game. Roadrunners lead the Cyclones.
The first real offensive opportunity there for the Cyclones. They're always a patient team, you can never count them out. They don't like to run and gun. They slow down the pace of the game, and they like to be as meticulous as possible when it comes to that, and they finally get their first offensive opportunity. Good save from Johnson.
Face-off won by the Cyclones, but it's recovered in here by the Roadrunners, and coming with speed, they come back. That's tipped off the stick of Vinny Pontrello. Pontrello still does battle. Pontrello battles in the corner. The 2-17s do battle, Lauren Barron and Pontrello. John Seamer tips that one behind. It's Rob Alexander doing battle with Pontrello. Alexander takes it to Barron. Lauren Barron gives it to Rob Alexander. Alexander leaves it to Lauren Barron. Barron in his own end to Sean Garsh. Garsh up on the wing to John Seamer. Seamer now behind his own net. Cuts in front. Taken away, and there's a penalty coming up as Renaud has his hand up. Penalty will go to the Roadrunners.
It's a good call from veteran official Steven Renaud, who actually made his AHL debut in this past ice season. So he's an excellent hockey official and one of the top American officials in the United States. And that was a great call there because it denied a scoring opportunity. Maybe that might not have been a hook up here in the neutral zone, but because it denied a scoring opportunity and obstructed that chance, good call. And the Palmer Cyclones, who always have an excellent power play, head of the man advantage.
And that's the one thing. If you're the Roadrunners, you have to stay out of the box. There's no question about it. You have to stay out of the box.
This is a lethal power play.
Lethal, and you're absolutely right. Controlling the puck now is Brett Olinger. Olinger, no. Back to Olinger. Olinger, Travis, no. No takes the shot, that's deflected out of play by Austin Rezegi on the PK.
That's a good play from Rezegi. You got to be a little bit aggressive. You know that one of the top two guys is going to try to get shots, and he pounced on no the second he knew he was going to shoot it and block that opportunity.
Looks like Rezegi, Heinzman, and Swims are the three penalty killers. It's no, Olinger, Garsh, and there's a shot that's blocked by Rezegi. Beg your pardon, by Heinzman. Rezegi will recover. Rezegi looks, gets taken out of the play by Travis No. No takes it again. No takes the shot, fires it over top of the net. Garsh races after it off his skate and plays it in the corner all the way back into his own end.
No doesn't miss there very often. Opportunity missed there for the Cyclones. Prime scoring area for No.
PJ Musico in net for the Cyclones. Olinger wants to take the shot, got it back door, it scores. Olinger to Garsh, and Garsh ties the game at one. On that power play was Walser, Garsh, Olinger, and Travis Snow, and they pump it home, and we're all tied at one here. 13 minutes left in period number one. Ryan Marker loses the draw to Travis Snow. Brett Olinger plays it up to No. No, gets it rink wide to Joey Durant. Joey Durant takes it now. Durant tips it in. Travis No has it in the corner. Okada plays it behind. Roadrunners want to slow things down. Sent in behind the net. The longer this game is tied for the Roadrunners, the better. Even if they're in the lead. And that's the one thing they can't do. They've turned the puck over a lot in behind the net already. Timmy Janke turned it over there. Brett Olinger in front lost control. And Roadrunners try to recover, but they cannot. And it's taken right back by Palma, who will look to slow things down with Travis No. No gets it wide to Parker Conant. Conant tried to feed it in. He was looking for Brett Olinger, but it didn't get that far, and now it's Conant again on the half wall. Conant in the circle, gets it down below the net, and that was Travis Noe trying to feed it back to Conant. Didn't work. Sokol gets it off the board, and they come back 3-on-1. It's Marker. Marker tries to settle the puck, cannot. Marker still with the puck, now has to turn. Marker got it in front to Sokol. Sokol back to Nick Okada. Okada to Marker. Marker couldn't get the shot off, and it goes out of play. Deflected out of play by the defense of the Palma Cyclones. 11.5 left in the first period. We're tied at 1.
If you're Tour, you cannot turn the puck over in your own end, especially behind the net. And you know it's going to be an aggressive forecheck for Palma. When they want to, they're going to come strong, and they have some of the best forecheckers in the game. So you have to be smart and read and react the play and make sure you get rid of puck quickly when you need to.
Settled back down now by the Roadrunners. Vinny Pontrello gets it to Max Halvorsen. Halvorsen in behind his own net. Will halt there, defended by Tyler Walzer. Interesting story on how Walzer got on this team. And at some point during the tournament, we will get there and let you know how that happened. It's a good, interesting story. Halvorsen can't get it, and Walzer will come after it, coming 2-on-1 with Jordan Thomas. Halvorsen back checking. Here's Walzer getting it to Thomas, just too far for him, and Thomas sets it back into his own end.
Good back check from Halvorsen there. That really forced a bad pass because they saw him coming with a lot of speed from behind with the back pressure, and the pass was forced ahead of the intended target. So good play from Halvorsen on the back check.
Walters to Barron. Barron to Walzer to Thomas. Thomas got it back to Walzer. Backhand blocked at the defense, and it'll be Barron almost turning it over, but it's taken right back by Zach Walters. Walzer goes to the bench for John Seamer. Lauren Barron has it. Pressure there by Steve Martini. It's Thomas getting it to Seamer with speed. Seamer comes through the neutral zone. Here's John Seamer cutting to the middle, takes a shot. That's deflected over top of the net. Comes right back in behind the net for Seamer. Seamer still has it. John Seamer defended there. Seamer in behind the net, looking for a man in front. Found Barron, but Barron fanned on it. Coming back is Halvorsen. Halvorsen turns back and gets it in behind the net. Joey DiMartino gives chase. DiMartino trying to come away. Barron plays him, lost control of the puck, and it comes back to Sean Garsh. Garsh comes back now on the circle, cleared it in front, and that's blocked away at the defense. Steve Martini, great defensive job there. It's Lauren Barron still with the puck. Barron on the half wall, now turns in the circle, fires that one wide. That's Sean Garsh, I beg your pardon. Garsh on the half wall. Garsh in front of his own bench, plays it back into his own end for Rob Alexander. Alexander now comes. Puck bounces on him, but it's settled now by Brett Olinger. He plays it in, but it's taken right back by Austin Rezegi. Rezegi off the boards in his own end to Joey D. DiMartino plays it back to Heinzman. Heinzman in behind his own net. We'll wait there.
No pressure from Palma, so no need to force anything.
And I don't think you'll see a lot of pressure in behind the net from either team. Marker has it. Marker looks for Swim. Swim fires one wide. Comes out in front of that and recovered now by Palma. Olinger gets it up ahead, and starting back now, Rob Alexander. Alexander, top of the circle, got it to Olinger. Olinger looks rink wide for Garsh. Garsh between his legs, fires one, stopped by Johnson. The rebound's blocked, and Marker starts away for the Roadrunners. Marker gets it up ahead. Looks like Rezegi coming in, takes that shot, deflected into the netting, and out of play.
Pace of this game has really slowed down. It picked up for a bit there a couple minutes ago, but since then it's been real slow and ridiculous, but that's what you expect from teams like this. That's obviously going to be the Roadrunner strategy, and that's the way Palma's been playing for years.
Face off to the left of Musillo, won by Palma. Travis Noe to Joey Duran to Lauren Barron. That pass too far for Noe. Off the boards from Janky to Rezegi. Rezegi gets it back to Okada. Okada to Janky. Timmy Janky curls on his own end. Janky halts back there. Marker comes to the circle, gives it to Janky, back to Marker. Off Marker's skate, Marker plays it, gives it away to Travis Noe. Travis Noe starts away. That's not the person you want to give the puck away to. Travis Noe, backdoor, great save, Keith Johnson, another save by Keith Johnson.
Unbelievable, goes from left to right, right pad, robbery. That's a huge, huge save. We'll see if the Roadrunners can use some momentum from it.
And it's a huge turnover by Ryan Marker. Marker turns it over to Travis Noe. If there's one person you don't turn it over to, it's Travis Noe. Joey Durant has it. Durant plays it to Noe. Nick Okada on Travis Noe right now. Okada does a great job, and Sokol does a great job helping out Okada. And Okada, Sokol comes in with the shot. Nusil makes the save. Comes up, Barron hit by Okada. Sokol helps him out again. Sokol has it in the corner. Sokol plays that off a skate into the corner. Janky gives chase to it, but he's pressured out off there by Zach Walter. Comes in now. Sokol hooked down. Penalty coming up now and going to the box will be Parker Konen of the Cyclones. That was all because of the fierce play by Okada and Sokol. Sokol came up with the puck three times on that shift. Sokol got taken down, and the power play comes up now for the Roadrunners. Palm already has a power play goal. Roadrunners will try to score one here.
Big power play here for the Roadrunners. A great opportunity to get their lead back. They need some good puck movement and get some shots on Musico.
Settling the play down is Joey DiMartino. Gets it back to Heinzman. Heinzman gets it across to Rezegi. Rezegi. DiMartino, Rezegi, Heinzman. Comes back now, here's Rezegi, backdoor, great save, Nusilo. DiMartino, Rezegi, DiMartino, try to get it across to Heinzman. Back now to Rezegi. Heinzman has it. Heinzman looking, Rezegi, Heinzman. Heinzman top of the circle, now DiMartino in the corner. DiMartino, Heinzman, Heinzman, Rezegi, fakes the shot, got it backdoor. Here's an opportunity now. Roadrunner still with the puck. It's Rezegi. Heinzman. 40 seconds left in the power play. Heinzman has it in the circle. Heinzman, Rezegi. Rezegi, Heinzman. Heinzman, shot save by Musilo. Taken and bounced off the boards by Rob Alexander. And it'll be Rezegi recovering. In the corner now. Comes back up top, Rezegi. Taken away by the Roadrunners. Sent up ahead, John Seymour on the PK with 10 seconds left. Seymour in the circle. Seymour lost control of the puck. Heinzman will give chase to it with Seymour. Heinzman and Seymour do battle on the corner. Heinzman kicks that away, but back to even strength now are the Cyclones.
Good kill from Palma there. See if they can take some momentum from it and get the lead for the first time in this game.
I've got to find out who number 7 is on the Cyclones, because I don't have that up here. Trying to look exactly who that would be.
I got you, Georgia. Look online. You keep calling in.
Check it for me. Thank you, sir. Appreciate it. Starting away now is Aaron Schwartz for the Roadrunners. Schwartz in behind the net. Schwartz lost control. Comes back now. Schwartz racing after it. Lost control once again. Recovering is Martini for the Roadrunners. In behind the net to Halverson, who has the lone Roadrunner goal. Halverson defended by Walzer. Martini curls in his own end. Martini crosses the red line, goes right back. 4 minutes left in the first period here. Other than the power plays in the first 4 minutes of the game, this play is slowed to a screeching halt. Up on the wing now. Roadrunners want to start back. Vinny Pontrella. Schwartz makes the line change as Swims jumps over the boards. Swims, an awful turnover there by Swims to Ty Walzer. Walzer takes that shot. Johnson kicks it into the corner. Walzer races after it, but it's taken by Timmy Janke. Now the Roadrunners. Another turnover. Walzer takes it in front. Scores!
Great forecheck by Walzer. Wins the individual battle in the corners. That's what it's all about. Winning those 50-50 pucks. He did. He walks out front. Right on top of the crease. He's not going to miss from there. Rings the doorbell. Puts it off the bar and in. And Palma has their first lead of the game and of the tournament.
And here's the problem, Trefty. That's not even a 50-50 puck. That's a Janke turnover. Two glaring turnovers there on that shift. One by Swims, one by Janke. You're not going to win the game turning the puck over like that against Palma, especially in your defensive zone.
Exactly. A team with the caliber that Palma has and with the guys they've added like Walzer and other players like that, you can't make turnovers or it's going to cost you. They're a team that's not going to miss if you give them the opportunity.
In over the line is Alexander. Travis Snow. Got it rink wide to Parker Conant, but he lost control of the puck. Now it's Snow. Getting it back. Snow curls around in the zone. Now back to Parker Conant. Conant to Rob Alexander. Alexander holds it there. Travis Snow now brings it over the red line. No. Gets it to Parker Conant. Backhand way over top of the net. Comes into the corner. Travis Snow and Bobby Sokol to battle. Coming with the puck is Rezegi to Sokol. Leaves it there. There's a shot. Score! Janke! Janke and Sokol came in 2-on-1. And the Roadrunners tie this game at 2 with 1:52 left in the first period. So Roadrunners score first, Palma gets the next two, and now the Roadrunners have tied it. Nick Okada takes the draw, in behind his own net. Okada with the puck. Turns, lost control, it's a turnover there. In behind the net is Sean Garsh. Garsh. Defended well by Okada. Garsh cuts to the middle. They try to take that away, but Garsh plays it off the boards to himself and puts it back into his own end. Now back forward to Zach Walters. Walters to Joey Duran. And Garsh poke check by Martini. Okada played Garsh well. Martini gets it to Marker, who has a shot. Marker took that shot, blocked by Walters. Walters now has it. You've got to be effective when you have control of the puck. Got to make yourself relevant. Right now, there's some players on the Roadrunners who are not doing that. They're turning the puck over more than anything, and you can't have that. Under a minute left in the first period. Over the line is Olinger. He's defended well by Martini. Comes into the slot. Okada plays it back, tipped away, but goes right to Martini, who will play it back to, looks like Tommy Heinsohn back there. Tommy Heinsohn with 25 seconds left in the first period, in behind his own net. Points are so important here. You play four games and only the top 6 out of 10 teams make it to the playoffs. You go 2-2, you may not even be guaranteed a playoff spot. Okada lost control. Walzer starts away, got it rink wide. It's off a skate and it's tipped into the slot and with 3 seconds left, dumped all the way down. And that'll be the end of period number one. At the end of one period, Cyclones, Roadrunners, tied at 2. We'll be right back. come back here for period number two. Still a brand new hockey game, all tied at two.
And you have to think, George, that's a huge accomplishment for the Roadrunners. Coming out of the first period, tied at two with the Palma Cyclones.
Absolutely, because you don't expect that if you're the Roadrunners or anybody else in this building.
Only 18 minutes left in this game. They have an opportunity to win it. You can't sit back and look at it and say, well, that's a victory. That's a victory just tying after the first period. You have an opportunity to win this game. Be smart, limit the turnovers, and you'll be fine.
Absolutely. Let's see if either team made any adjustments here for this second period of play. Barron plays it back into the slot. Jordan Thomas overskated the puck. Heinzman lost control. Thomas took it right back. Thomas back into his own end. Tipped up there. Ty Walls were going after it, but Okada takes that away. Nick Okada looks in back into his own end. Okada goes forward, then breaks his stick, trying to go back. Nick's going to go to the bench. Sent back in, oh man, and Barron was all alone, but Barron now has it behind the net. Lauren Barron with it. Barron gets it over to Jordan Thomas. Thomas has it, top of the circle. Tries to cut in the slot. Joey DiMartino tried to cheat on him, but Thomas got it into Barron. Barron fires it. Keith Johnson makes a save as Barron didn't get good wood on it.
I would have rather have liked to see Barron maybe catch that pass and try to take it in a breakaway and do something. Instead, he tried to catch Johnson off guard and deflect it. Not a terrible play, but I think with the skill of Barron, he would have had a better opportunity coming in one-on-one. Granted, it was a bit tight. Wouldn't have had much room, but his hands, I would have trusted him for sure.
It's No and Rezegi in the faceoff here to the right of Keith Johnson. No wins it, tries to keep possession. He does into the corner. Travis No behind the net. No plays it back to the point. Joey Duran, Travis No. No leaves it there. Rob Alexander almost overskated the puck. Alexander defended by Sokol. Sokol grabs him. Sokol's going to go to the box.
Nobody's arguing that. Vio's more yelling at Sokol than he is the referee right there.
Right.
Clear hold.
He played the angle wrong, so he had no choice but to grab him. And so now, 2 minutes into the second period, we're still playing here. 5-on-4. They cannot cross back over the red line since the goaltender has been pulled. It's Duran to Travis No. No. Gets it in the corner to Seamer. Seamer cuts out in front, takes a shot. That one's blocked at the defense. Comes back in front, and Sokol touches up, and Sokol will go to the box for a hole.
Nice job by Sokol. He know he took the penalty, and he came back in the play. He not only made an excellent block right on top of the crease, but then he got the touch to get the whistle. A lot of guys get frustrated that they took the penalty. They kind of give up on the shift, but he finished the shift hard and made sure it didn't cost him. We'll see if they can get a kill.
No to take the faceoff against Vinny Pontrello. Back to the same power play. It's going to be Alexander, No, Walzer, and Garsh. Walzer down low here. Takes the pass from No. Walzer tried to get it back to No. It's deflected off of Swim stick. Swims, Heinzman, and Pontrello will kill. Travis No, top of the circle. No wants that shot. No doesn't take it. Alexander, No. Here's the shot saved by Johnson. Rebound scores. Walzer is second in the game, and they take a 3-2 lead. And the power play for Palma is 2-for-2.
Such a heavy shot from Travis Snow. And Johnson just couldn't control it. He got a piece of it, but it just trickled out in front. And Walzer, he's a guy that's near impossible to move out of the front of the net. Thomas Holmstrom style stands there. Gets the rebound, puts the biscuit in the basket, and Palma has their lead back.
15-18 left here in the second period. Rob Alexander controls and will go in behind Musico, but he'll go with speed, and he wants to start out. Alexander gets it up ahead to Sean Garsh now. Garsh takes a shot, fires it wide of Keith Johnson. Coming up ahead now, looks like John Seamer. Seamer to Garsh. Garsh fires one, saved by Johnson. And starting away with it now, and I've got to make that change because I think number 12 is Andy Zubak, not Timmy Janky. So Timmy Janky may be number 7, and Zubak number 12. 'Vio always changing his roster, so we never know exactly what's happening here.
Just keeping us on our toes, that's all he's doing.
I guess, because I know he's not. Walzer again fires that one over top of the net. And I don't mean coaching wise, I mean with his roster. I mean, guy never has it complete, paperwork never done. Leo knows I love him though. 3-2 here. Bama wants to start away, and they do. Barron picks it up after Walzer tips it to him. Barron pressured from behind by Ryan Marker. Marker falls down, but Walzer helps him out there. Barron finds a puck, tried to get it up ahead, but to Jordan Thomas, it's deflected away by Zubac. Zubac in. Zubac lost control, checked off by Jordan Thomas. Rezegi does chase after it, almost took the referee out. Rezegi in behind the net, lost control, and Lauren Barron has it for the Cyclones. Barron wants to start away. Barron gets in over the red line. Lauren Barron plays it back now. Ollinger checked away by Martini. Steve Martini starts away. Martini tried to get that one in on net, but it's blocked off of the defense by Travis Noe.
No need to force that one there. You had another man with you. Don't put it into a shin guard. And luckily for him, it pinballed over to the wall instead of back to the way, which would have been a costly turnover. But no need to force that there. If you have two guys, two on two, be a little more smart with that puck coming in. Try to score.
Walzer plays it in behind his own net. Palma slowing the game down here. 13 minutes now left in the second period. Palma leads 3-2 on the strength of two power play goals. Rob Alexander gets into the slot, defended off. Okada lost control. Okada tried to take it back from Travis. No one does. Okada wants to turn away. Tried to get it over to Tommy Heinsman. Okada plays his man off. Okada takes a face rub from Parker Conant. Played back now by Travis Noe.
It's a nice job by Okada to play physical. You know Palma's going to play physical, so match that intensity. Nice job there from Okada.
Okada's going to play physical. He always does.
Yeah.
Good player. He'll just have to watch his turnovers today. He broke his stick earlier. Can't do anything about that. But
yeah.
Heinsman bumps his guy off, Rob Alexander. In behind his net now, setting things up once again. Will be Joey Durant. Durant up on the wing. Here's Travis Noe. Noe fires it over top of the net. Defended by Heinsman. Heinsman wants to start away with it. Heinsman does. Gets it up to Rezegi. Rezegi got it in front. That one went wide of the net. Noe and Heinsman do battle again. Heinsman pokes it in. Janky wants to race after it. Comes in behind the net. Taken back by the Cyclones. They start away and then slow it down. Sent up on the wing. Here's Sean Garsh. Garsh in the circle. Garsh halts back there. Garsh plays it off the boards and all the way back into his own end for Lauren Barron.
Palma is at their best. When they have a lead, they can slow it down and just force you to get bored and then make mistakes. That's what they're trying to do right now.
And over the line is Sean Garth trying to get to the front. Defended well by Joey DiMartino. Schwartz has it. Schwartz plays it in behind the net to Halvorsen. Halvorsen takes it, gets it up through the middle. Sokol chucked off the puck by Travis Noe. Beg your pardon, that's Lauren Barron. Comes in Seamer, got it behind Garth. And Sokol again off the boards. Sokol wants to go, gets it up to Joey D. Joey D has room. Joey DiMartino fires one wide. He had a chance there. Played back now. Seamer lost it to Sokol, and now it's Joey DiMartino recovering again. Looking back to slow the game down, and will. Back to Halvorsen. Next game coming up will be Mission Black Ice against Fibero Cyprus.
That's going to be a fun one, George.
It will be. All these games are going to be just absolutely phenomenal because one loss could mean the difference between your playoffs and that. Remember last year, the 5 and 6 seed made it to the championship, and the number 6 seed, Snipers, were the 6 seed, won it all. Halvorsen behind his net, in behind the net, Peter down in front. Swims will be the first guy there. Swims not playing for the Vibero Cyprus. More of a mutual decision there, but we'll have more on that story later. Up until a couple days ago, he was a Cyprus player, and now he's not. So we'll talk about that a little bit later.
Speaking of changes to the Palma Pro Invitational for this year, you actually get a cash prize for each individual game.
Yes.
In the round robin. It's not just meaningless games or well, it's none of them meaningless trying to make the playoffs, but every single game, something on the line. So even if you're out of it, there's something to play for.
Absolutely. Back door, that pass was made, and a great save there by Musico. And behind the net, now another shot from a tough angle. Shot stopped by Musico. Now Garsh does battle him in the corner. Garsh comes out with it, tried to kick it ahead, could not. It's taken right back now by the Cyclones. Brett Allinger back there. Allinger plays it to Alexander. Rob Alexander up on the wing. Allinger back to Alexander. Alexander crosses the red line, got away from marker. Alexander with a chance, goes wide. Alexander now in behind the net. Alexander cleared out in front. There's a quick shot. Johnson had to be quick on the save. Marker plays his man off, and it comes right back now, and it's Andy Zubac. Zubac up on the wing to Joey D. Makes one move around Jordan Thomas. Joey D gets it across now to Adam Swims. Adam Swims back to Joey D. Martino. They come two on two. Joey D comes to the slot. Joey D gets around one. DiMartino still has it now. DiMartino in the corner. Holds on to the puck. DiMartino looks in the corner. Got played off the puck by Zach Walters. Comes to Ryan Marker for the Roadrunners now. Marker to DiMartino. Everybody's standing on the Roadrunner bench. Everybody's seated on the Palma Cyclone bench. Roadrunners want this goal bad, but taken away. Swims, another turnover. Comes to Marker. Marker trying to play to Steve Martini. Cannot, and it's taken away by the Cyclones once again. Cyclones have a two-on-one if they push it. Comes back Jordan Thomas. Thomas looks, fires it wide, and the Roadrunners want to start back, but that one goes around the boards quick, and it'll be recovered by Alexander of the Cyclones. Off the boards now. Walzer can't recover it. It'll be taken by Sok, by, I beg your pardon, by Zubac. Rezegi gets it all the way back into his own end. Swims, goes off. Okada comes on. Okada in behind his own net. Okada played it to Steve Martini. Martini now gets it over. Crosses a red line. Martini halts there. Lost control of the puck, but Heinzman gets it to Okada. Okada does chase after it in the corner. He fell. He was giving chase to Parker Konen. And starting away now will be Zach Walters. He lost control. Okada on the back check. Gets it to Heinzman. Heinzman gets over to Rezegi. Rezegi wants to go. Rezegi thinks about it and then curls back into his own end. Rezegi to Heinzman. Heinzman gets a lot of playing time here from Vio.
He's a guy that's really stepped up in the game of roller hockey. You know, he's a younger guy playing in junior ice hockey, and now he's getting an opportunity to really play a lot of inline, and Tom, he's showing that he's a force.
And Heinzman has always had great hands. He used to be a bigger guy, so he didn't have much speed, but he's gotten faster and smaller, which is a great thing for Tommy. He's worked at that. Okada got that puck checked away from him. Sent up ahead, and it'll be Johnson racing after it. Johnson gets there first, but it's taken by the Cyclones once again. Up on the wing, it's Rezegi. Rezegi plays it back into his own end. It's Tommy Heinzman. Heinzman plays it back to Halvorsen. 5:40 left in the second period here. 3-2 lead for the Cyclones. Halvorsen in behind his own net. Looking to set something up. He's out there with Schwartz, Rezegi, and all the way down to the other end is Timmy Janke. Vinny Pontrello, I beg your pardon. Around the boards, it's Rezegi looking back to Halvorsen, but he plays it to himself off the boards and taken away now by Travis Noe.
There's the one disadvantage of having all these small, younger players.
Yeah, but at that point, don't you throw the puck back here. I mean, why do you go against the Travis Noe one-on-one there against the boards if you're Rezegi? Comes in the slot. Garsh, the head fake. Garsh tried to take the shot upstairs, but it goes off the side of the net. Around on the boards, he puts it, and it's taken right back into Joey Duran, who takes it into his own end. Sent up ahead now for Seamer. Seamer crosses the red line. John Seamer gave it to Sean Garsh. Garsh gets it back to Rob Alexander in his own end. 4.5 left now in the second period. Still lots of time left, so no need to press anything or rush anything just yet. Comes to John Seamer, Rob Alexander. It was right on his net, so Musico tips it to Alexander. to Sean Garsh. Rink wide, it goes to Seamer. Seamer defended by Halvorsen. Seamer still with the puck between his legs. Backhand fired it wide. Halvorsen lost control, but it's tipped back and behind the net to Janky. Janky gets it on the boards. Adam Swims will be the first one there with 4 minutes left. Swims a backhand pass to Sokol. 2-on-1 with Halvorsen. Halvorsen trying to get it to Sokol, and that was too far. It goes right on net as Musico pushes it away. Sokol still has it now. Good quick play by Swims there to get that puck up for a 2-on-1. Into the corner, they do battle. Halvorsen, Sokol helps out. Sokol looks back, and Swims is all alone back in his own end, and he'll have it to set things up. It Swims to Sokol. Sokol settles it down to Halvorsen. Halvorsen gets in over the red line, being chased by Walzer. Halvorsen cross-checked down by Lauren Barron. The puck is touched up by the Cyclones, and it'll be a power play for the Roadrunners. 3:29 left here in the second period. Roadrunners will go on the power play to try to tie this game.
My assumption is that a timeout might be called by one of the two teams. Either that or VO's just getting a quick pep talk in right now before they head into the faceoff dot.
You've got to think somebody like Bobby Sokol will probably play after this power play. If he doesn't, he's got to get on the power play quick. Because right now it's going to be Joey D, Heinzman, Janky, and can't see who else is out there. But in any event, Sokol's not there yet, but he's at the end of the bench. You know he's going to be the first one to jump after he gets a little breather here. Off the glass. And it's up ahead to Jordan Thomas, who's on for the kill. Thomas has it. Thomas lost control, regained it, but coming back to help out was Janky. It goes to Rezegi now. It's Rezegi, DiMartino, Heinzman, and Janky. Heinzman to DiMartino, to Heinzman, top of the circle. Heinzman's got a great shot. See if they use it. Heinzman, top of the circle. DiMartino, Heinzman. Heinzman, DiMartino, Heinzman. He wants it, takes it, fires it over top of the net.
Got to hit the net there.
Comes back now to Heinzman. Heinzman, DiMartino, DiMartino, Heinzman. Heinzman looking for Rezegi, finds him. Rezegi, Heinzman. Heinzman has it, top of the circle. DiMartino, DiMartino, Heinzman fires one, saved by Musico. Dumped into the corner, but the first one there will be DiMartino. Half a minute left in the power play, 2:30 left in the regulation time. Comes back now, Heinzman to DiMartino. DiMartino across to Rezegi. Got it in front, they score! Janky ties the game at 3 in front of the net. 2:23 left in period number 2.
Look out here, George. The two Roadrunners tied with the Palma Cyclones with 2:23 left. And remember, in the Palma Pro Invitational, there's no such thing as a tie. We go to a shootout.
You're right. We will go to a shootout. And not only will we do that, but remember, this is where the big-time teams are made. The last 2 minutes of a game tied at 3. Will a team come out on top? And you'll see who is playing in this game now. If I'm Veal, and now, again, I'm going to remind everyone, I am not coaching at this tournament. I am a broadcaster. I am not biased in the situation. But if I'm Veal, Ryan Marker is not out here in this situation for me. Marker has a tough time when he has to cross over. He has a tough time when players cut to the middle on him. He has a tough time staying with them. So let's watch on that. And that's Marker's guy who just almost got the puck there as he's defending against Duran. But it looks like they're playing a 1-1-2 into a man-to-man system, so they're not leaving Marker out there by himself. But the one thing Marker does have is an amazing shot. But Marker never goes to the puck, and Noe has it all by himself in front. Fired wide. Great back check there. Great save by Keith Johnson. Comes to Heinzman. Marker has a great shot, so that's probably why he's out. But in this situation, you want somebody defensively out there. But I could be wrong because Marker has the puck now. Marker plays it back into his own end. Marker gets caught a lot. Coached him at Tours. He gets caught a lot treading away from the puck instead of coming to and attacking the puck. And that's what happened there. Instead of stopping on the boards, he was already gone out of the zone when that pass was made. So let's see if that hurts him at all. But Vio wants his shot out there. So with a minute left, he's still out on the rink.
Vio being aggressive. He wants the win. He wants the full 3 points. Doesn't want just two.
Contrello coming back. Backhand saved by Musico. And Musico will hang on. And we'll have a new group coming over the bench. For the Roadrunners, two of them will come. It'll be Martini and Rezegi coming on for Marker and Pontrello. So under a minute left now. We're tied at 3 here in the second period. Swims has it in his own end. Swims defended by Seamer. Swims with it off the board. Too hard, tried to get it to Heinzman, but first one there is Martini. Pressured by Olinger. Olinger takes it to Garsh. Possession is so important here in the last minute of play. 35 seconds now left in the second period, and still counting, tied at three. John Seamer in the corner. Remember, a regulation win is 3 points, shootout win is only two. So are you going for the 3 points here? Seamer, defended by Martini, checked away, comes back now. It'll be Olinger getting it to Zach Walters. Walters lost it, it hopped over a stick. Here's Heinzman with 12 left. Heinzman, top of the circle. Heinzman defended well by Walters and up on the wing, looking for John Seamer, taken out by Martini, but coming back is Garsh. Garsh lost it, tripped up by Martini, but not enough for a penalty there. And it comes, and that's touched up, and that is the end of regulation. Tied at three, we're going to a shootout here in the first game of the Palma Pro Invitational number two.
And you know, those are good plays by Martini, because even if he takes a penalty, the only thing that happens is he's not going to be allowed to shoot in the shootout.
Absolutely.
And he's not a guy that's going to shoot in the shootout anyway.
Absolutely.
So he takes two penalties right there that weren't called. Even if they were, it doesn't matter. It's 5 seconds left.
Five, 6 seconds left. You win a face-off, the game's over.
Yeah.
Regulation's over.
And you're not going to... He's a guy that's going to be one of the last shooters in the shootout. And with all these players that are in this game, there's no way it's going to get that far anyway. That was an excellent play by Martini. I'm not sure if he was thinking that way or he just got caught and had to take the
guy Martini down. Steve Martini's a vet. He's been around forever. First time I saw Moneymakers, 91s, when they were peewees. So, I mean, he's been around forever. As Black Ice comes out of their locker room, getting ready to play for Barrow Cypress here. First time Black Ice has been here. They were not in it last year. They could not get all their guys together, but they've been a successful program. Last week or a week and a half, 2 weeks ago, they were knocked out by, I believe it was RPD at NARC. But here we go, first shooter, ready to go. Janky, get on goal, forehand, saved by Musico.
And this is a place where Musico is gonna thrive. He's a guy, I'm not sure how much roller hockey's been playing because he's a professional ice player. Saw him play many times last year for Greenville against my Atlanta Gladiators. But he's a big guy, a lot of athleticism.
Ty Walzer, first shooter for the Cyclones. Walzer in on goal on Johnson, fires and scores, glove side.
He's been the star of this game for Palma, 100%. And the makeshift hat trick there, not officially hat trick, doesn't get credit for it, but still is his third time putting the puck into the net this game, and all three of them have been excellent tallies.
Here's Ryan Marker to shoot. Marker's got a great shot. Marker in on Musico. Marker to the forehand, scores! Ryan Marker.
I like how he slowed down at the end there and really forced Musico to almost guess where is he gonna go. And when he took the shot, such a quick release, no chance.
Here's Parker Conan, in on Johnson, backhand saved by Johnson. We are even here, going to our last shooter before sudden death if we're still tied. So shooter number three.
Four-man shootout, George.
Three-man shootout. Three-man shootout.
Well, Tim told me wrong.
Yeah, Tim said four in the meeting too, but then changed it to three. So, well, let's see. Sokol, backhand! Oh, it stopped in there by Musico.
He had him beat. Yeah, Musico dead to rights. He just put it off the side of the net.
And who else would go as the third shooter for Palma? Travis Snow.
Sounds like a rap song.
I've been known to spit a couple verses, bro. Travis Snow in, looks to the forehand. Keith Johnson with the save. We stay even here, going to shooter number four for each team.
As this gets deeper into the shootout, who do you think has the advantage?
I don't know. I have no clue. Rezegi in, looks to the backhand, scores! Austin Rezegi!
Yeah, Musico almost turned around.
Yeah.
That was brilliant stick handling. It wasn't flashy like Travis Noah likes to do, where he goes big inside and outside, just quick little fakes. It fooled Musico once he bit, put in the back of the net.
John Seamer. Saved by Johnson, the Roadrunners win game number one, 4-3.
Wow. Hey,
Anything can happen.
It's the Palma Pro Invitational. What have we talked about the whole time? Because it's an invitational, because of the deepness of this, so you can't bring your own random team, the best players from those usual other teams, come to the top 10 teams in the tournament. Anything can happen. There's so much talent. There's no one team that's so much better than anybody else, and the Roadrunners just proved that there. There's a lot of people that said that they were one of the teams that weren't going to make the playoffs, and they just, you know, a very good statement here in this one.
Yeah, well, folks, that's it from game number one of the Palma Pro Invitational. Palma Cyclones fall to the Tour Roadrunners by a final score of 4-3 in a shootout. Coming up next, Vivero Cypress and Mission Black Ice. That'll be coming up next right here on State Wars Hockey Live from Fort Wayne, Indiana.
Division between your home team, Mission Black Ice, and your visitors, Vivero